You hear that? We're alone.
Good. You know, I love our friends.
Oh, we have lovely friends.
Yeah, and family.
Oh, the best.
But this, I mean, just you and me. You know what? Marrying you was the smartest thing that I ever did. It's right up there with marrying you the first time.
You are so right. You know the only thing that's missing?
Food.
You're the last of the fries.
That dress, and you know your way around the kitchen.
Don't you get any ideas, McBain. This is a one-time thing, and only because I like it.
All right, Jeff. You know what to do with this. When you're done, why don't you take the rest of the night off, okay?
Thanks, boss.
You closing early?
Yeah, I thought I would.
Why? What are we doing here, John? Where are we?
You feel the breeze?
Yes.
Keep your eyes closed. Okay, you can open them.
Oh my God, this is beautiful. You did this?
Oh, yeah. A little help from Roxy.
I thought the wedding was magical, but this... Thank you, Brody.
We gonna take this inside?
I've got you right where I want you.
Really? Might have to take this hand, take it deep in your pocket and get the key if you don't open the door. Incoming!
Ah, well, 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 looks like somebody else had the same idea.
Oh, well, that has got to have been one of the best weddings I've ever been to.
Yeah, especially when you think about everything they went through to get there.
Bo and that skunk?
I'd take a skunk over a burned eyeball, a chipped tooth, and a fried head of hair.
Well, now she did it, but she looked great.
They both did.
Did you hear from Shane?
Yeah, he texted me after the birthday party, and Tyler's mom said he could sleep over.
You said?
Yeah.
So he's not home?
I think that's an important part of sleeping over at someone's house.
So, when you said that I could bring you home, did you just want a ride, or can I come in?
Old-fashioned wedding to get people in the mood, huh? You two planning on sealing the deal tonight?
We are having a nightcap.
Oh, one nightcap. Did you hear that, Elijah? My dear cousin's having a nightcap with her new boyfriend.
Reed is an old friend, Blair.
Not even her boyfriend. You completely surprised me, Kelly. Ex-wife, mother, having a nightcap. And a menage a trois. What's up, Sean?
What's up, Miss Kramer?
Good. You three have a very good time.
That was pretty slick what you did back there at the wedding, giving me the slip.
Sean, I'm sorry. I can't.
I have a job to do, and I'm not letting you out of my sight.
So how's that truce going with your cousin?
Come on, Elijah. I'm just having a little fun with Kelly. Well, that's who we are. I mean, we're just...
A lot alike.
Well, I am definitely smarter, better looking, and way more talented.
I mean, come on. She wanted to sing at Bo and Nora's wedding. I did her a favor by stepping in there tonight.
Actually, Blair, you did yourself a favor by proving to one and all that you can conduct yourself like a lady in public.
Oh, now, counselor, do we need to call a truce here?
Ooh, you can take it.
Yeah, and who told you that?
Nobody. I just know. Because I know you.
It's been so long.
Question.
What?
At the wedding, did you think about anything?
The honeymoon?
What about marriage? You ever think about that?
So where did you learn how to roast the perfect marshmallow?
The SEALs.
The Navy taught you how to toast marshmallows.
Part of our training.
No, it wasn't.
But ma'am, are you questioning a Navy SEAL? You know, we were taught to survive.
On marshmallows.
Well, I could dig you up some tree roots if you want. And actually, the SEALs have a saying, you know, the difference between triumph and tragedy might just be a marshmallow.
Ah, depending on whether you're in a swamp or a supermarket, huh?
Exactly. And since tonight is all about triumph, yours and mine,
we're eating marshmallows.
What do we have here?
What's that?
Let's see. Oh, dear John, I know I shouldn't be writing this.
You saved my letter.
Excuse me, I'm reading. But I can't help the way I feel about you. I've tried to deny it. I've tried to fight it. But there's something that keeps pulling me back to you.
So you brought me here to humiliate me?
I'm sorry, did you or did you not write this?
Because Roxy made me. I was going to get on a plane to London and live miserably ever after, but no, she made me spill my guts.
And if you hadn't, we wouldn't be here right now.
I had cookies, lots and lots of cookies, so that people had something to munch on after the cake was gone.
They ate the entire cake?
Oh, my God, and what they didn't eat, they dragged home with them like ants.
Okay, are you sure the kitchen's closed?
Oh, over an hour ago. I mean, whose idea was it to give away candles and not chocolate?
Hey, you know what?
What?
That little mini-mart out there by the highway, they stay open 24 hours a day.
I could eat beef jerky at my wedding night? Oh, come on.
Mr. and Mrs. Buchanan?
Yeah. Hey, I thought the kitchen was closed.
It is. This is special delivery.
Oh, my goodness. Thank you so much. Thank you. Thank you.
Yes.
Thank you so much. Thank you. What?
To the most gorgeous bride and most fragrant groom. We figured that you didn't have time to eat at the reception. Happy wedding night, Natalie and John. Thank you.
Are we sure we want to do this?
I did it again.
Oh, no worries. I like them burnt here.
Well, I don't.
Well, then stop being so impatient, okay? You got to hold it away from the flame.
And turn it slowly. I know, I know. You are going to be teaching Bree how to toast a marshmallow, okay?
I'm on it.
I'm sorry.
For what?
How about everything that I put you through? You rescued me from Mitch, and I pretty much tortured you. I mean, if you had done that to me, you know, hung all over other women and pretty much make me jump through hoops or shoot them just to go on a date with you, I would have killed you. But not you. You are so patient and kind, and you're so good to me.
I love you.
No. This is a little above and beyond that.
Jess, you and me, we're not like other people.
What do you mean?
Well, I met in St. Anne's. You say, I'm not going to walk out on you just because...
I lost my mind for a little bit.
I'm serious. You know, the fact that you understand what it means, what I went through, you're one of the few people on the planet I trust. So I don't care how many times you fall or how far. I won't let go of the rope, no matter what.
So, if I hadn't written my letter, you'd still be with Marty?
Well, like I told you at the airport, Marty broke it off with me. I'm not saying the letter changed how I felt. It's just,
Marty had just lost the baby, and you weren't about to leave her. And then she read my letter, and she had too much pride to stay.
Yeah, I think it was hard for her seeing it there in black and white.
I mean, it's not like she didn't know what happened between us.
You know, we've been trying to move on. You know, because what everything had happened, and I just don't think she could let herself see that what we felt was real.
So is that why we're together, that you do the right thing and I don't?
You did the right thing.
So maybe it's just that no one else will put up with us.
Or maybe we just belong together.
So is that why you dragged me here with my letter in your pocket?
I thought you said you could eat a horse.
I could. Two. I'm worried about my tooth. I mean, this is only temporary, and it was put in by a first-year dental student.
Come on, honey. Oh, why don't you just say something?
Oh, you're so sweet.
How's the eye?
Well, I mean, I can see out of it. How's it look?
It's okay, but... Right? No, well, it's a little redder than the other one, but no, it's okay.
Is it?
No.
Well, I can't believe my ankle held up with all the dancing.
I didn't even know you sprained your ankle until the reception.
You see me. I was trying to figure out, how do I walk down the aisle with crutches and a bouquet? And then we were going out the door, and then all of a sudden the sun came out, a rainbow came out, and my leg felt better, and it was the power of love.
Which tooth was it there?
Oh, it's this one.
Okay. All right.
Okay. All right. What? Bad? What?
No. I heard a rumor about your hair.
Oh, God. It was green. Roxy. She put some chemicals in it. I have no idea. But she got it. She got it looking okay.
Mm-hmm.
It's a good thing. Other than that, I've been going down to the aisle to... Here comes the one-eyed, snaggle-toothed gimp with a bag over
honey,
her head.
Honey, I would have married you anyway.
Oh.
If you'd have had me. I was pretty ripe.
What do you mean?
I had a close encounter with a fully loaded skunk.
You're kidding me.
No, I'm not. Oh. No, you got me good, too. North, south, both sides. Tore up my tux. Tore up half of St. James.
What did you do?
Well, I sat in a bathtub, marinated myself in tomato juice, while Matthew just ran around detoxing the entire church.
That's why I keep wanting to put vodka over you and sip you like with a stalk of celery. So, why didn't you tell me?
Well, why didn't you tell me about the ankle, about the tooth, the eye, about your hair?
And the dress? The dress burned.
Oh, God.
Yeah.
Honey, I don't know. Red, I'll tell you, I don't know if this is a good way to start a marriage. Keeping things from each other.
I have a picture.
Me too.
Show me yours, I'll show you mine.
Right.
Okay.
I thought we left you at reception, Sean.
No, you mean you tried to give me the slip. Sorry, son. Dr. Lord hired me to keep Kelly safe.
She's perfectly safe with me. We're just gonna have a nightcap.
In your room?
No, in the corridor, Sean. Yes, in my room. Now, if you wouldn't mind hurrying along.
I'm not going anywhere.
Suit yourself.
Thank you.
You okay with Sean outside the door? Please tell me you don't feel frightened.
Frightened? No. Maybe a little embarrassed.
Why?
Well, let's look at that. Blair and Sean both seem to think there's more to this nightcap than a little brandy in a glass.
And they'd be right. I didn't invite you to my room for a drink, Kelly.
I don't have to think about marriage because I've been married many times, Elijah. You?
Never. Come on, Blair, you know that. I've thought about it once. Maybe twice, but it didn't feel right. You know that thing that you're supposed to feel, that click? Mm-hmm. When everything starts to make sense and you suddenly can't imagine your life without that other person?
Well, you've always had your career.
I've been busy. It's true. Mm-hmm. But it's more than that, actually. I never felt the need.
Well, then you're lucky.
But I do now.
What do you mean?
You, Blair. This feels right. I mean, everything's fallen into place.
Are you proposing to me?
I'm a lawyer. If I were proposing, you'd know it.
Well, good. Good, because you scared me there for a minute.
Why? I've been married before.
Yes, I have many times, more than I can probably count on this hand. And most of those times have been to Todd, and you know they were a disaster.
I am not Todd.
You are proposing to me.
No. I'm scouting. Yes, I'm getting a lay of the land.
Well, I'm not going down that road again.
Well, if that's true, Blair, then we have a problem.
Don't you think it's a little soon? I mean, this is only our second date.
Third, if you count the time in London when I poured my heart out to you and you rejected me flat.
That doesn't count.
Why not?
Because I was living with my ex-husband and we were trying to keep the family together. And, you know, I think dating you, that would have never worked.
And now? With Zane in boarding school and your ex an ocean away.
I didn't come here just for a drink.
Sorry to interrupt. This just came for you.
Who dropped it off?
Messenger service.
What, this late? Where's it from?
Statesville Prison.
You were always there for me, Jess. You accepting me. What I did. When I shot that boy, that's what healed me. More than the therapy, your faith in me brought me back. And that's what I was trying to do for you.
Even though I kept pushing you away.
No, I was a SEAL. You know, we're trained to outlast the enemy, whether it's Miss Lawrence or amnesia.
But I was the enemy.
No way. You had some short-term memory loss. I just had to be patient and keep showing up.
But what if I never came back, you know? I mean, there were no guarantees.
I'm not perfect. I shouldn't have pushed it the night of the prom.
When you were trying to get me to remember?
Yeah, it was a mistake. I got my hopes up, you know. When we were dancing and you knew me for a second, I couldn't let it go. I just missed you so much. And I pushed it, and I never should have done that, and you were right to shut the door on me. But it hurt. I mean, that wasn't your fault, but it was a tough night. I kind of hit bottom for the first time. I stopped believing you were going to come back to me. I thought I'd lost you for good.
So in your letter, you told me to meet you here at midnight if I wanted to have a future with you. I didn't make it.
I wanted you here so much. And when you weren't, I felt my heart break and I gave up on you.
Let's fix that. All right? Tonight at midnight, I'm going to be here. You know, there's not too many people who are lucky enough to get a second chance.
Bo and Nora and Jess and Brody.
Maybe us.
Well, it's not that I don't want to. I do. It's just I'm not sure if I'm ready for what happens next. You know, like tomorrow and the next day.
I know.
But it felt really great.
Yeah, the best.
So, Balsam, if you want to put the brakes on things, you better start by putting on your shirt.
Right. Sorry. If you could,
Sorry.
No, it's beautiful. You're always so...
You too. Can we be honest?
Definitely.
There's something going on here. And there has been for weeks.
Well, months, ever since...
Stacy died and we found out that she and Kim...
Had been working us for almost a year. Yeah, I still can't believe...
You are on a mission to break two people up.
Who loved each other.
And ever since then, since... Stacy died and Kim left town. We've been good.
Great.
And you were there for me when Sierra was in the hospital and when Skylar was fighting me for custody.
And you came with me to New Mexico to help find my folks. I could not have done that without you.
And I couldn't have made it through after Stacy died without you. So in a lot of ways, it's...
Nothing's changed.
Except everything has changed and we can't pretend it didn't.
I don't want to pretend. I just... want you back.
I want that too. But I'm scared. What if...
Blow it again? Yeah, I know. I'd lose you for good.
And I'd lose you. And that just can't happen because...
I love you.
I love you. I love you, Rex, I do.
Midnight. Think you can take me?
I think you should stop talking and break.
I mean, are you a special friend of the warden or something?
Oh, no, no, no.
Oh, I have a few exes at Statesville. Oh, dear. Why would they send me a wedding present?
Honey, think. It could have been anybody. We put away a lot of crooks over the years. Hey, wait, let's just start with a card.
Okay. Me?
Yeah, come on. Wait, who's it from?
Your ex, Lindsay.
I want to get married. Someday. But if you don't, then I need to know. Now. Before I get in any deeper. I think that's only fair.
You're right. It is. It is fair. And I certainly don't want to deprive you of all the agonies of marriage. I mean, of course, there's always divorce, custody battles, property settlements.
Again, not Todd.
No, you're not. I didn't quite figure you the marrying kind, though.
Well, to the right woman.
Okay. How's this? Since you're not ready to propose and I'm not ready to walk down the aisle, how about this? Would you settle for maybe I'll think about it in the future, but only to you, so don't let the word get out. You took a mighty big risk then.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Tell it to my heart.
Oh, my God.
I don't want to lose you. Shall I notify housekeeping?
Waiter.
I shouldn't have said anything. We'd have made love.
Then what?
Waffles?
At least we know how we feel. Even if, you know, we're not there yet.
I hate feeling this way, scared to go for it.
Going for it, that's what got us into trouble in the first place.
You're right. We gotta do it different, better.
Yeah, especially because we have Shane to think about.
He's been through enough.
Although, this is what he would want more than anything, you and me getting back together.
I mean, you don't think... Never mind.
What?
This is just a risk we have to take.
It's a risk either way. But if we take things slow, then I think that ups our chances.
I don't have a clue how to do that. I just want to take you upstairs right now. But you're right. It's not enough, and I don't know what is.
Maybe too much has happened. Maybe we should just walk away.
All alone. I didn't have any past. I didn't have you. I didn't have Christian. So I felt like I had to find something new.
What do you mean?
Just that it was really hard for me. And the point is, you brought me back. I told you that I found this.
Your dad's house.
Yeah, I saw it on the floor, and I picked it up. And I remembered us dancing at Rhodey's. Remember when we couldn't tell anyone that we were dating? And I remembered my little girl. And remembered it because of you. You brought me back. You brought me home.
I always will. Here's a real Navy saying for you. Anytime. Anywhere. Always ready. Always there. And that is my promise. I swear I will never give up on you again.
How could I ever forget you?
I ask myself that every day. Seriously, if this ever happens again, I'm just gonna win you back. I don't care how many art teachers you throw in my face. I'm never letting you go.
You do win me back. Every day. Just by playing with Bree, or taking the time to reassure my parents, and my family, and my future. You're everything I ever wanted. And if you ever lose your faith in me again, I'm gonna hunt you down and drag you back home.
You are my home.
To Bo and Nora, despite everything I did to keep you two apart, your love was too strong, even for me. Enjoy this gift I made for you. People here tell me I'm very good at what I do. I wish you all the best. Forever, Lindsay. I think we should still call the bomb squad.
Oh, come on.
Well, I'm just kidding.
All right. Here, why don't we just go ahead and
are you open?
Unwrap it. No, come on. I want to see what she sent us. What is it?
A license plate.
No. Hey, we are not walking away. Now, I know a lot has happened, but we have survived worse. When I left you in Michigan, you were pregnant with Shane.
Yeah, I never thought he'd know you. Much less love you.
And that wasn't easy. I had to win him over. He hated my guts. And look at us now. Look how long it took you to let me in.
But Rex, if we're both scared and we don't trust each other and we don't have a clue, like you said...
Hey, what do I know? If we did it once, we can do it again.
How?
I think we need to forget about how we think it should look. You know what I mean? Like the way it was when we first met. Because it can't. You're right. We're different. I think we need to start over. Like we just met. Only this time we'll have an edge. We love each other. Now it's just step by step.
Starting with what?
Gigi Maresco. Will you go out on a date with me?
Are you still with me?
Yeah.
Liar. What is it? Can you still hear your cousin and her over-enthusiastic boyfriend?
No. No, that isn't it. It's just... Sean is right outside the door. It's just making me feel a little weird.
If I'm not your cup of tea...
No, you are. You are. You are. I've always been attracted to you. It's just...
Too much too soon.
Yes. Do you mind?
Not at all. How about that nightcap?
You gonna take your shot?
Right now.
I would love to go out on a date with you.
Great. Fantastic. See, I wasn't so hard.
So where are we going?
I'll let you know. Tomorrow, okay?
Nothing too fancy, because this is it in the fancy department, and I have to take it to the dry cleaners, and I don't know if I can wait a whole week.
Okay, no, that is a no. Definitely sooner than a week. Okay, then. You looked really pretty tonight.
You looked really great.
Glad we got to dance.
You're stalling.
What are you talking about?
Go, so you can figure out this stupid date and I can figure out what to wear.
Goodnight kisses are allowed, right?
Yeah, but just one.
One? I had a good time tonight.
Me too.
I'll call you tomorrow.
Better.
Touching heat, freezing on my skin. I've pretend.